Let's begin our new topic, that is chapter number 6, Janapadas and Mahajanapadas. Before starting the topic, I would like to discuss the political system which we have seen in the previous chapter, that is chapter number 4, Vedic Civilization. Okay, in the Vedic period, each village has a head known as Gram. The group of villagers formed of Vish, whose head was known as Vishapati. Several Vish form a Jana. Several Vish, ऐसे छोटे छोटे wishes को form करके एक Jana बनता है, right? And later when Jana settle into a specific region, it come to know as Janapad. The head of the Jana was known as Nrip or Raja, a king. The main duty of the king were to protect the people and collect taxes and run the administration efficiently. So students, in this chapter, we are going to see different Janapad and Mahajanapad, okay, their rules we are going to see, their names we are going to see. So which are the major Janapad? Mahajanapad, that is Koshala, Vatsa, Avanti and Magad. Let's see their location in the given map of India. Students, this is the map of India which is showing 16 Mahajanapad. And you can clearly see this map of India in your textbook. Okay, so underline one is Koshala, Avanti, Magad and Vatsa. Okay, so students, we are going to study about this region in detail. Let's see about Janapad. Janapad, the period from about 1000 BC to 600 BC, it is considered to be a post-Vedic period. It is this period that Janapad come into existence. Janapad were many small state, but spread from today's Afghanistan, which is to the northwest of India subcontinent, to Bengal and Odisha in east, and to Maharashtra in south. The Janapad, called as Ashmak, occupy a part of today's Maharashtra. समझ में आया, अश्मक कहाँ पर है? महाराष्ट्र में है. The name of this Janapad can be found in Sanskrit, Pali and other Magadhi literature. One can also find information about them in writings of Greek historian. Some of the Janapad were monarchies, while other are republic. Some Janapads had a Gana Parishad of senior citizens. Members of Gana Parishad come together for discussion and made decisions regarding administrative issue. The places where these discussion took place were known as Santhagar. Gautam Buddha hailed from the Shakya Republic. Every Janapad had its own coinage. Okay, so students, we have seen about Janapad and Mahajanapad. Let's go in detail. First, we are going to see about Koshala, next Vatsa, next Avanti and next Magadha. Okay, so first we are going to see about Koshala. The Koshala Mahajanapad was located in the foothills of Himalaya in region of Uttar Pradesh and Nepal. Shravasti was the capital of Koshala. of Kosala, Prasenjit. Gautam Buddha Vihar, Jetwan at Shravasti. Now, Gautam Buddha had lived in famous Vihar Jetwan at Shravasti for long time. The Kosala's king Prasenjit was contemporary of Gautam Buddha and Vardhaman Mahavir. Later, the state of Kosala merged with Magadha. Vatsa. Vatsa Mahajanpad, located around Prayag, Allahabad in Uttar Pradesh. Kosam or Kosambi is capital of Vatsa. Students, this Mahajanpad is located in the region around Prayag. And where is Prayag? It's in Allahabad in Uttar Pradesh. Okay? And Kosambi is the capital of Vatsa Mahajanpad. It was an important center for trade. Three extremely rich merchants of Kosambi had built three viharas of Gautam Buddha and his follower at Kosambi. Let's look at the picture. Vatsa King Udyan. This is a picture of Kosambi, ancient city of Kosambi. Students, three extremely rich merchants of Kosambi had built three viharas for Gautam Buddha and his followers. Okay? And King Udyana was a contemporary of Gautam Buddha. After King Udyana, the state of Kosambi could not maintain its independent existence for long, and the king of Avanti Mahajanpad conquered the state. Okay, then after that Avanti rule came into existence in the same place. Next, we are going to see about Avanti Mahajanpad. Avanti. Ancient kingdom of Avanti was located in the Malwa region of Madhya Pradesh. Ujjaini, that is Ujjain, was its capital. The city was an important trade center. The king of Avanti was Pradyot, and he was contemporary of Gautam Buddha and Vardhaman Mahavir. During the reign of Nandivardhan, the state of Avanti was merged to Magad Empire. Magad King Bimbisar. He is a famous physician of Bimbisar Jeeva. Magad region is located at Gaya, which is in Patna in Bihar. Capital of Magad is Rajgriha. Yes, capital of Magad is Rajgriha. King Bimbisar's palace was built by the architect called Mahagobi. Okay, and Bimbisar had become the follower of Gautam Buddha. Let's see ways of Magad Empire. Ajatshatru, the son of Bimbisar, continue with the policy of expansion of Magad Empire. He successfully conquered many republic of the East. The kingdom of Magad prospered during the reign of Ajatshatru. He had become the follower of Gautam Buddha. After Mahaparinirvana of Gautam Buddha, it was during his reign that the first Buddhist council or Sangati was held at Rajgriha. The foundation for new capital Patligram of Magad was laid during Ajatshatru period. Later it became famous for Pataliputra. Pataliputra was probably in the vicinity of today's Patna city. A noteworthy successor of Ajatshatru was Magath king Shishunag, and he annexed the kingdom of Avanti, Koshala and Vatsa to Magath. Nearly the entire region of north then India come under the control of Magath. That was how Magath empire took shape. Next is Nanda king of Magath. The Nandas ruled the Magath empire between 364 BCE and 324 BCE. They had set up a good administrative system necessary to run the huge empire. They had a huge four-column army of infantry, cavalry, chariot and elephants. The Nandas also introduced a system of standard wages, weight and measure. King Dhananand was the last king of Nanda dynasty. But this time the Magath empire had extended up to Punjab in west. However, during Dhananand's reign, the ambitious south Chandragupta Maurya won Pataliputra and end Nanda regime and laid the foundation of Maurya empire. In next chapter we will read about the foreign invasion on western and northwestern frontiers of India during the rise of Maurya empire, and also we will read about Maurya empire in great detail. So students, with this I am finishing chapter number 6, Janapad and Mahajanapad. Let's go with the activity. That's all for now students. We'll be meeting in next lecture with very new topic. Okay, bye.